welcome. Today's workout is my dumbbell arm circuit workout. It is awesome. So you're gonna need some dumbbells. At the very least, I want you to grab one pair of moderate dumbbells, but if you can also grab a pair a little lighter than that moderate set, your arms may thank you near the end. All right, grab your dumbbells, grab your water bottle, let's go get busy. Welcome, I'm PJ from fitnessbooth.pj.com and Bella and I are in the house to give you a dumbbell arm circuit workout. So like I said, you do need a pair of that moderate set of dumbbells, and then if you've got a smaller set, maybe grab those too. Now let's put them off to the side because we've got to get you warmed up and ready for this workout before we start going. So here we go, let's do some big arm circles, get those abs engaged, open up those shoulders, yeah. So we have five exercises on the chart, five rounds, 40 seconds on. Now I'll let you know when we get to the third round, or the final third round, and you'll probably know it too because you're with me. And that way, if you're a beginner, that may be where you want to tap out and continue on with your day and work up to the five sets. Deal? Good. All right, last three, two, one. Okay, open and close the arms now. On this position, we're opening the chest, and then when the arms close front, we're opening the upper back. So it's another lovely day in Vancouver. I say that dripping with sarcasm. It's gray, it's wet, it's disgusting. My dog is soaked because if you own a dog, you know that they love to hang their head out the window, the car window. So that's what she did the entire drive here, and she's soaked. Last three, two, and one. Feet hip width apart. We've got some walkouts with mountain climbers to continue warming up the upper body, but also now to get into the core a bit. So bend the knees for me. Walk out into a straight arm plank, wrists under the shoulders. Now step nice and wide, left foot to left pinky, or as close as you can. Feet together, other foot, feet together, and walk out. Great job. So we've got about a minute of these, and as I said, warming the upper body up as well as into the core. Nice little hip opener here too when we step forward. Yeah, wouldn't that be cool if we were like our dogs? We're just hanging our heads out the window. It's that much fun. Could entertain us and put us in that much joy. It really doesn't, does it? We could try it. Hang our heads out the windows. Actually, sad story. I just recently read a girl was doing that leaving Miami, I think it was. She was hanging out of her car, her friend's car passenger window saying, "Goodbye, Miami," and fell out and then got hit by a Range Rover and was killed. Yeah, that's not a good way to go. So maybe don't hang your head out the window, okay? Last one here. And release. All right, grab a sip of water because we are gonna get busy. Okay, keep moving those feet, grab a sip of water. I've got two things I wanna chat about really quickly before we start the workout. First, have you subscribed to the channel? Hey, people who subscribe do less burpees, so it's in your best interest. You can subscribe down below, and while you're at it, click that notification bell so I can let you know every time I drop a workout. And then second, have you checked out my Patreon community? Come on over, become a member. This is a community I am creating for women who want to be fit and fierce over 40. I've got all the information down below, and I will also attach it at the end of this workout. All right, put your water bottle down. Let's go start sweating. All right, at home, grab onto your dumbbells. If you have two different sizes, obviously start with the heavier set, okay? I'm starting with 12s. I've got a pair of 10s that I can tap out to if things get a little rough. Our first move is a burpee squat press. So yeah, we start off with a bang. With the burpee, let's get a full push up in. So it's down, full push up. I'm going on my knees so I can take it deep, and then wide squat so that we can bring the dumbbells up and press up above the head. Full engagement of the abs so I don't lose my low back. All right, And where would we lose our low back? Well, we would lose it to the physio because that would hurt. Here we go, 40 seconds. Don't worry, I'll show you the rest as we get going. All right, let's go down. Push up from the knees or toes, just make it pretty. Jump up, squat up. Good, good, go. Push up, triceps, arms, chest, presses, shoulders, arms, core involved here. Woo, we got it all. Almost there. Time. All right, two arm row, next move. With the row pattern, we want to lean or hinge from the hip. So bum goes back, neutral spine. That's important. So when we're not rounding, it's that lower back area, okay? Be aware of that. Push the hips, arms slightly in front, both arms row up. Elbows go past the rib cage, pushing those elbows up high, squeezing those shoulder blades on the top part of the contraction. Abs engaged so we don't feel our low back, okay? Combo drill coming up next with a press and a triceps. So now we've got back muscles, biceps, shoulders, time. Woo! All right, now, I like a staggered stance when I'm doing an overhead press movement because I find that it helps me support my low back. So you choose what works best for you. Pull your belly button in to tighten up those core muscles. Now, give me a press, straighten the arms. Good, now, palms facing each other, drop the dumbbells behind you for a tricep extension, go back, palms facing away, and return home. Press, triceps, straighten, lower. Press, triceps, oh yeah. 12s, we're ambitious on this one, PJ. That's what I am, ambitious and stupid all at the same time. The perfect combination of idiocy. Renegade row and a plank coming up. Time. All right, taking ourselves into a straight arm plank, dumbbells under shoulders. Now here's a couple of different variations you can do. All right, to modify, you'll tap the knees on the ground, but still keep that tush down. If you're in this position and find your hands on top of the dumbbell too much, you can place one in between the hands and then alternate, okay? Go, so you choose what's gonna work for you. If your legs are straight, let's have those feet apart. Keep those hips squared. Good, whoa, Bella! Oh, did that mat scare you? Mat just fell on her. There you go, lie down, girl, good girl. Now she's not going to trust that. She's not going to trust that area of the gym now. That's a good girl. So back muscles, biceps, shoulders working again. Done. All right, flipping over onto our backs, bringing the booty up so that we work into the glutes. Elbows lined up with the shoulders, wrists over those elbows. When we get in that position, press the dumbbells up above the chest and down again. Good job. Good girl, Bella. She's not even gonna look at me now. So this is the fifth move, okay? So second time around, we're gonna perfect the form even further. So we're still kind of learning the movement patterns. I'll keep coaching you. By the third round, you will be a pro. Get that booty up there, squeeze those glutes. That fun burpee, push-up, squat, shoulder press coming up. Time. All right, standing position. Okay, so we start with the burpee, push-up from the knees, feet a little wide perhaps so that we've got a clean looking squat when we come up. Yeah, let's go down. Woo, push-up, up, press, woo. Thank you. get the heart rate up too, won't it? Oh yeah, PJ, no problem. Do your best, okay? Done. Now, if you're starting to get tired, the next round, I'll show you how you can modify that burpee. All right, we're in that fold position, hinging from the hip joint, okay? Abs engaged, arms in front of the shoulders a bit, and pull up for a row. Bella, you're not even gonna look at us? Bella, baby girl, good girl. Overhead press, tricep extension, coming up next. Stop. All right, so this is the one where I cue you. Perhaps you want your feet, your legs staggered. All right, tighten up your glutes. Abs engaged, we don't want to feel this in our low back. Now start with the press, okay? Then hands are gonna face you so that you can come back for the triceps. So they're almost like kickbacks, okay? Oh yeah. Now, if you're like me, you've got one arm stronger than the other, or one tricep stronger than the other. So one arm might be wobbling a bit more than the other. Woo! This is a good test of the metal of those triceps. So the tricep muscle composes actually about 2/3 of our arm. So that's the important muscle to tone when you want to hit arms and look smoking hot in a tank top. Time. All right, Renegade row. So this was your option. On the knees if you need to modify. And then either position you decide to do with the knees, you can have one dumbbell under the chest if you find hands on top of the post, too hard on the hands. Feet apart, good. Hips squared, don't rock and roll those hips. Back of the neck is long, so take a look ahead of you slightly. Rolling onto our backs for a chest press coming up next. So chest press, I like to do it with the bum up so we get some glutes involved as well, okay? So feet apart, heels in close to the bum, elbows lined up with the shoulders. Now drive the hips up, get the booty right up there, and press. So triceps are helping out on this move again. Shoulders are working, pecs are working, and then because we've got the bum lifted, we've got the glutes and hamstrings involved too. Round three coming up. When we get to the top of the move, the burpee, I'll show you how you can modify it. I should have showed you the first round. Sorry. Bad trainer, bad. But it's really easy. Essentially, you're gonna do a squat and shoulder press. Top. All right, so you're kind of sick of burpees, not interested in doing them. Feet hip-width apart, drop the bum back, press up, drive up. That's your move, okay? All right, the rest of us, here we go. Burpee, round three, go. One day I'll be able to do a perfect straight leg push-up. Today ain't the day, though. Push-ups are getting harder. Almost there. Done. We're there. Awesome. I'll save that push-up for the next round. All right, bent over row. So where's our bent part? It's from the hip, okay? It's not from the low back. So from the top of the thigh, push the hips back, fold forward and row. Abs engaged, we do not want to feel our low backs. Chest is lifted, but just a bit. We want gravity to come down on those back muscles. Overhead press, tricep extension coming up. Staggered stance if you like, but tighten up the core regardless, okay? Hands start at the shoulders and they can, palms are facing you or they can be facing your computer or TV set. All right, now press up, triceps, straighten, lower. Press, triceps. Great job. Renegade row coming up next. Oh man. So I read a story this morning in the UK, two elderly sisters that lived together woke up and found their dog dead. He was 18, so I guess they were kind of expecting it. So they had a little funeral for him and they buried him. A couple days later, somebody found the dog, died. He wasn't dead. Luckily, they were elderly and couldn't really dig a deep hole, so the hole was quite shallow, so the dog was able to get out, and he still had his collar on, so he was reunited with his family. Renegade Rose. It's kind of a sad and funny story all at the same time. Funny if you're twisted like me. If you've ever read Stephen King Pet Cemetery. So apparently, here's a lot of things happening on social media about Pet Cemetery and these sisters. But that's good. He's 18 years old and dug himself out of his own grave. I love that dog. That's spunk. Chest press coming up next. Done. My dog is so lazy, I don't think she'd bother digging herself out. She's such a diva though, somebody would find her and dig herself out for her. She totally is such a diva. And press. I created a monster. But the poor sisters too. Can you imagine how devastated you would be if you found out you buried your dog that's alive? Oh. So, the news report said there were a lot of tears during the reunion. But yeah, I guess some passerby found the dog on the side of a road. Time. All right, round four. So, if you want to tap out, you go right ahead. Work yourself up to the five rounds. If you're ready to go with me, we've got the burpee or the squat press. Your choice, all right? Ready and go. Two-arm row. So again, it's that hip hinge. So take the dumbbells and come just the very top of the leg. So not at the waist, just around the groin area, for lack of a better term. Now, hinge from that area and row. My first dog that I ever had, I got her when I was 19. Anyways, I found her dead. It's very sad when you find your dog dead. We guess she had a heart attack in the middle of the night. And yeah, but the other two dogs I've had to go and put them down. Actually, I'll be honest, Larry had to do it. I couldn't do it. I put a cat down once. Time. Oh my goodness. I was crying for days. And it wasn't even my cat. It wasn't my cat. It was my dad's cat. Oh, so I couldn't imagine putting my dog down. I couldn't do it. Here we go. Press to triceps. I come off as some tough swearing trainer, but I'm a big softie. Oh. And I find in menopause, and if you're a menopause, perhaps you can relate, I can cry at the drop of a hat. I cry in commercials now. I find everything just so emotional, uplifting, not sad crying. I'm just like, oh, that's so beautiful. Oh, Jesus, PJ, get a grip. It's a fucking commercial. Oh, Renegade Rose, done. Woo. Woo. I think it was a car commercial, actually, that I was crying at. It was really well done, though, okay? Just gotta say. All right, Renegade Row, from the knees to modify. From the toes, dumbbells under the hands or in between the hand, and go. Comment below, what's the silliest thing you've ever cried at? I hope I'm not alone. You must have cried at a commercial, too. Come on. Don't leave me hanging. A good friend of mine, she's pregnant. She's 5 months now with her first. I cry every time I think about her having a baby. I cried when she told me. I cried when they found out the sex. I cried, I bought the baby his first pair of Nikes. He's not even born yet, but done. Chest press, I cried buying those. Not sobbing, but I held it together at least that much in the Nike store. All right, chest press, bum up. And press. But I've known her since she was 19. And now she's mid-30s and having her first baby. I better stop talking, I'll start crying again. So this isn't that bad. I haven't had to drop down my dumbbells. How are you doing at home? I put a little longer break in between the moves just so we get a little muscle recovery, right? We don't want to just keep pounding out reps and losing form. So that has helped. Time. All right, our final set. So if you stayed with me, you got to stay to the end now, all right? You are staying. So burpee, all right, or squat shoulder press, your choice, but let's finish strong this final set. Go. Oh. God help me when she actually gives birth. I'm gonna be a mess. I better be at the hospital. They better call me. I better let her know. She has to call me. Her husband has to call me as soon as she goes to labor. I gotta be there. Two arm row coming up. Ooh. Done. Woo! All right, no more burpees until next workout. All right, hip hinge. All right, abs are engaged. We do not feel our low back. We could hang here all day. We've got neutral spine. Go, strong core, and now we're working lats, mid back, back of shoulder, biceps, pumping out those reps all the way to the end. Come on. I just figured out why Bella's not looking at us. She's keeping an eye on the mat that fell on her. That dog remembers. She does not forget. Woo! Done! All right, abs engage, shoulder press to triceps. This one is gonna be a little tough, fifth round of these 12s. Woo! I kinda like the 15 seconds in between the exercises. Go, why don't we do this more often? If you're new to my workouts, it's normally 10 second break, which is enough. And it's usually 10 seconds because I have A, a ton of exercises I want to show you, and B, I'd like to keep the heart rates up so the flow stays. So we got to keep the flow of movement, not slow down, not stop, keep moving. Renegade rows coming up. Oh yeah. Time. Oh yeah. All right, you got your row pattern. Knees, toes, you choose where the dumbbells are. Hips are gonna stay squared though, okay? So really focus on this final set, making this one tight and clean. Elbows brushed by that rib cage. Now take a look up a little bit. Don't let the head drop. We want the back of the neck long. You got this, 40 seconds. Drive the hips up, squeeze the glutes, and press. Come all the way down with every rep. So the back of the arms are hitting your ground every rep. Go through that full range of motion. Dumbbells press up and touch above the chest, not the head. So our last exercise. Triceps is burning. This feels awesome. Time. Come on, I'm not the only sick one that loves the burn. All right, shake out those arms, grab a sip of water. We gotta do a couple of stretches before I send you on your way. All right, hopefully you grab some water. Let's do a couple of stretches and then you can continue with your day. Take that left arm across, thumb up, press into the chest. Just feel that stretch, upper back, shoulder area. I'm so happy you could join me. Don't forget, drop a comment below. Let me know what silly things you've cried at. Make me feel good. Make me feel like I'm not the only loser who cries at commercials. Take that hand now back and pull it down a little bit. Be gentle, get the tricep and then lean away. I'd also love for you to subscribe. Easy for me to say, subscribe if you haven't already. And then click that notification bell. Release, other arm. And then as I said in a little commercial break, if you've done my workouts in the past, I would love to have you join our Patreon community. It's a community of women who are getting fit and fierce over the age of 40. So if that's something you wanna do, head to the link I've got down below. And it's also gonna trail across the screen in any second too. And triceps. Little lean. And hands light behind the ears and pull the elbows back and then look up a bit. So we're opening the front of the body, getting a stretch through the chest. And let's round the shoulder blades. Now bend the knees, separate the shoulder blades, tuck the chin in. Bring the arms up over the head as you lift up, circle them behind you. And you did it! Hey, thank you so much for joining me. I appreciate your support and I look forward to reading your comments below. Bye. Good workout, Bella? Is this a good workout, Bells? Good job.